Hey, Henry Kaiser here with my canine companion, Mr. Snowshoe. He's a young one. I have the great privilege of living with this dog, which is a Swedish Laphund, very rare dog, almost extinct. There's almost none in the United States. He's an Arctic dog from the north of Sweden, and he had a very unusual job. His job was to be a watchdog, kind of, but a problem-solving watchdog for reindeer herds, for the Sami people, for the nomadic people following the reindeer herd. And he's an unusual little guy. At any rate, he loves reindeer. And before we get to this week's show, which is a holiday show that I just put together today, because the show that was supposed to be this week isn't quite done yet, a big extravaganza with a lot of people in it. But Snowshoe asked me if I was going to do a holiday show, could I do something about reindeer? I can't really do that. That's because my dad was a singer, and I have an example here for Snowshoe and you of my dad singing probably the most famous reindeer song, and it's what Snowshoe wants to hear. He wants to see reindeer, so here we go with my dad singing a reindeer song.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you go down in history.
Well, Snowshoe is out running off the excitement of the reindeer. Two Christmas items, two holiday items for you in this week's show. First, we're going to hear a poem from the 19th century, a very famous one, probably the most famous Christmas poem. And it's a propaganda poem. Back when this was written, Christmas was a working man's holiday. You'd go out, you'd get really drunk, you'd break some store windows, you'd steal things. That was kind of a typical American Christmas then. It wasn't like we imagine Christmas now. And this poem was written to try to change people's behavior at Christmas and make it a stay-home family thing and not a drunken, carousing, law-breaking holiday. So here we go. A Visit from St. Nicholas by Clement Clark Moore. 'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be. Were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads, and Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cap. Had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter that I sprang from my bed to see what's the matter. Away to the window I flew like the flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes did appear miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer with a little old driver, so lively and quick. I knew in a moment he must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled, and he shouted, and he called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer, and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner, and Blitzen. The top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, and Saint Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof, the prancing and pawing of each little hoof, as I drew in my head and was turning around. Down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler, just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled. His dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses. His nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him, in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk. And laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh. His team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." All right. Now, to wrap things up today, we have a song, a tune, that's thought of as a Christmas tune. It's not. It's kind of a tune of how to get laid in the winter for guys when you see all the lyrics, because all the lyrics are left out of the way we sing it at Christmas. And it's an odd thing to hear all the lyrics. So I hope you enjoy it. I hope everybody has a good holiday month, whatever holiday you observe. And we'll see you next week with a very special extravaganza show. Okay, bye. Jingle Bells. It's not quite what it seems. It wasn't originally associated with Christmas. It was written by James Lord Pierpont and published under the title One Horse Open Sleigh in the autumn of 1857. No connection to Christmas, but it became associated with Christmas music and the holiday season in general. They usually leave off some verses. Let's do the whole thing. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, o'er fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. A day or two ago, I thought I'd take a ride, and soon Miss Fanny Bright was seated by my side. The horse was lean and lank. Misfortune seemed his lot. He got into a drifted bank, and then we got upsot. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. A day or two ago, the story I must tell, I went out on the snow, and on my back I fell. A gent was riding by in a one-horse open sleigh. He laughed as there I sprawling lie, but quickly drove away. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Now the ground is right. Go it while you're young. Take the girls tonight and sing this sleighing song. Just get bobtailed bay, 240 for his speed. Hitch into an open sleigh and crack, you'll take the lead. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells.